Good evening, students. Today we will discuss some important questions on matrices. We have already discussed about the matrices, about the eigenvalue of matrices, about all types of matrices. Today we will discuss some important questions on the basis of matrices. Write down first question. If a matrix is given A equals, suppose we write down here a matrix which is a upper triangular, 5 5 alpha, and here suppose is alpha. This is the first row of the matrix, and now 0 alpha, and suppose this is the 5 alpha, okay, and again 0 0 and 5 0 0 and 5. If this matrix is given, then our aim and some condition is also given there, and suppose the value of this is 25. The determinant of A square is 25. Then find out mod of alpha. Then find out mod of alpha. The value of mod of alpha is 1 by 5, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, none. Okay? So it is clear that the given matrix is an upper triangular matrix. What is an upper triangular matrix? A matrix is said to be upper triangular if its lower entry must be 0. Means that all entry below the principal diagonal must be 0. There is no condition on the principal diagonal and upper side entry is. Okay? So if our matrix is upper triangular or lower triangular or diagonal matrix, in such a situation its eigenvalue will be its principal elements. Means that the eigenvalue of this square matrix is 5 alpha and 5. Directly one can write down. So the solution is, since A is upper triangular matrix UTM, so its eigenvalue is, equal to 5 alpha and 5. No problem. We know a very known result. The result is that the product of eigenvalue of any matrix is equal to the determinant of that matrix. Means that if our aim is to find the determinant of any matrix, then one can write down the determinant of A equal to product of eigenvalues of A. Okay? So the product of eigenvalues of A is 5 into alpha into 5 means 25 alpha. No problem? Okay. Once again, look at here. It is given that the square of that is equal to 25. So here, if we write down this, so it can be written as like that. By the property of determinant, one can write down the determinant of A square equal to determinant of A whole square. So from here, it is given that its value is 25, and here its value is 25 alpha square, 25 square and alpha square. So from here one can write down alpha square equal to 1 by 25, imply that alpha gives the value plus minus 1 by 5. No problem. Our aim is to find mod of alpha, so mod of alpha gives the value 1 by 5. So option number first is correct option. Very simple. So this question can be solved very easily with the help of eigenvalue of the matrix. If our matrix is upper triangular, lower triangular, diagonal matrix, then its eigenvalue, one can directly write down the product of all the principal elements of that matrix. That will be the eigenvalue. Okay? Now, write down another question. If A is a square matrix if A is a square matrix such that A square equal to A and B equals I minus A. Okay, A is a square matrix such that A square equal to A and B equal to I minus A, then AB plus BA plus I minus A whole square. Okay, AB plus BA plus I minus whole square equals. First option is that A, second option is that B, third option is that identity, and fourth option is that zero matrix. Clear? It's very simple question. Only by using the algebra of matrix one can solve it. Our aim is to find the value of AB plus BA plus I minus A whole square. Okay, so here one can write down A at the place of B, one can write down I minus A, and here also at the place of B I minus A this A. Okay, and plus identity, and here minus this square means identity plus A square minus 2AI. No problem? Okay. Due to identity it can be commutated, that's why one can directly write down minus 2AI. So from here one can write down after multiplying A minus A square, at the place of A square one can write down A. So A minus A and plus A, and here minus A square, so at the place of minus A square one can write down the value A. So it is A plus I minus A square at the place of A square A and plus 2AI. No problem. So A and A is cancelled out, this is cancelled out, this is also cancelled out. Here it becomes minus A and plus 2A. After multiplying identity matrix 2A, it gives 2A. So the overall result is that A. So our answer is A. Okay. So it's a very simple question. No problem. Okay. Write down another question. If A equals, question is, if A equals, we write down here a 3 cross 3 matrix, which is a square matrix, 1 0 0, okay, no problem, 0 1 1, clear, and 0 minus 2 and 4. If we write down A equal to this, then find out 6th A, this A inverse, if this is invertible, means that it is non-singular, one can check it is non-singular by taking out its determinant. Okay, 6th A inverse equal to A square, this, then find out the value of CD, then CD is, okay. Our aim is to find the value of CD. How we find CD? First of all, we write down its characteristics equation. The characteristics equation of any matrix A can be write down by that. A minus lambda I, and this is equal to 0. So this implies that 1 minus lambda, 0, 0, 0, 1 minus lambda, and here 1, 0 minus 2, 4 minus lambda, and its value is equal to 0. Okay, so from here one can expand around this 1 minus lambda, and here it can be written as this multiplied by this 1 minus lambda, 4 minus lambda, and here is plus 2, and this is equal to 0. So from here one can write down 1 minus lambda, here is that 4 minus lambda, minus 4 lambda means minus 5 lambda, and plus lambda square. No problem? And plus 2. So this is equal to 0. So from here one can write down 1 minus lambda, and here lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 6, and this is equal to 0. Okay?
No problem.
Now, after multiplying this, it gives lambda square minus 5 lambda plus 6 minus lambda cube, and here is plus 5 lambda square and minus 6 lambda, and this is equal to 0.
This is the characteristics equation corresponding to this matrix. According to the Cayley-Hamilton theorem, each square matrix satisfy its characteristics equation. So this is a square matrix. This is the characteristics equation of this matrix. So it must satisfy this. Okay. So by Cayley-Hamilton theorem,
one can write down a square minus 5a plus 6 minus a cube plus 5a square minus 6a, and this is equal to 0.
No problem. One can also simplify it, and this can be implied as a cube, and here is a square, here is also a square, so 6a square
plus 6a square,
and here is minus 5a, minus 6a,
minus 11a.
It becomes minus 11a. Now, here is the term 6, remainings now, so the term 6
plus 6, and this equals 0. Okay, so from here one can write down,
our aim is to find 6a inverse. So
6 can be taken on the left hand side, remaining terms transfer to the right hand side. After doing this, 6 equals a cube minus 6a square and plus 11a.
If we multiply by the a inverse, our operating a inverse in both sides of this equation, we get
6a inverse, and this is equal to a square minus 6a plus 11.
No problem. A square minus 6a plus 11. Now comparing this to this, okay, it is given that in the question 6a inverse equals a square plus ci and plus di. So from here the value of c is minus 6, the value of d is 11. So the value of c and d is nothing but minus 6 and 11. Clear? So this is a very simple question. Now write down a very new question of this year.
Question is that if P is a matrix,
it is given that P is a matrix okay, P is this matrix. Now let us suppose that A is a matrix 1 1 1 0. Okay, another matrix A is 1 1 1 0. One can write down, here is also this is 0. And we define here the value of Q, P A P transpose. If we define the value of Q, P A P transpose, then find P transpose Q to the power 2017 and P. Okay, what is the value of P transpose Q to the power 2017 and P? Very important question. Okay, look at here. If we find out P P transpose, then what it gives?
Under root 3 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, under root 3 by 2. Okay, it's multiplied by its transpose. Under root 3 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, under root 3 by 2. Okay, so one can write down it. This is equal to, if multiplied this to this, so it is 3 by 4 and minus 1 by 4. So 2 by 4 means 1 by 2. Okay, here is 3 by 4 and here is minus 1 by 4.
Now, if you multiply this to this, so it gives minus under root 3 by 4 and minus, sorry, here is plus 1 by 2 multiplied by this is under root 3 by 4. Here if you multiply this to this, so under root 3 by 4 and 3 by 4 and here is plus 1 by 4. Here is minus, that's why it's become 1 by 4. So it is 4 by 4, so it is 1. Okay, here if multiply this, it becomes 0 and it becomes 1. Means that it becomes 1001. No problem. If one can multiply this to this, so it is the minus under root 3 by 4 and this is under root 3 by 4. So it is 0. Now multiply this 1 by 4 and here it becomes 3 by 2, 3 by 4. So 4 by 4, this is 1. So this is identity matrix. Means that whenever we find PP transpose, its value is identity. Imply that P is nothing but P is nothing but this equal to P inverse. P transpose is nothing but this is P inverse. Okay? There is no problem. In this step, clear. Okay. Now, if we find out the value of P transpose Q 2017 and P. Okay? So, from here one can write down the value of Q to the power 2017 P. Okay? What is the value of this? The value of Q is P A P transpose and 2017 and here is P. Okay? So from here one can write down P transpose P and here is A to the power 2017 and P transpose P. So it gives A to the power 2017. Okay? A equals A to the power 2017 and A to the power 2017 one can write down from here. Okay? So it becomes A after multiplying this. So from here 10 and 10 2017. Okay? No problem? Clear? From here one can write down the value of A square. We can find out a pattern. On the basis of that pattern one can find out 2017. So if we find out A square 1100, so it gives the value, this 1, this value gives also 1, this gives 0, this gives 0. Okay? No problem? So whenever we put A to the power 2017, it gives the value, here is 1100, no problem. Okay? Clear? So this is the something about the matrices. We have discussed so many questions on the basis of matrices on this, like that. Okay? Write down a question and do it. The question is, if A is a singular matrix, if A is non-singular, if A is non-singular and let us consider that it is also given that A minus 2i and A minus 4i, this is equal to 0. Okay? Then find out the value of 1 by 6a plus 4 by 3a inverse and this is equal to identity. We have to show that this. Okay? We have to show that this. Or find out the value of this, this is equal to identity. Okay? You can do so many questions. Okay, thanks class.